If you've ever lost your AC in the middle of a heat wave in the middle of summer and then wanted to murder somebody, go ahead and hit that like and subscribe button, folks. Welcome back to live trading here. We're going to go ahead and make some money. My AC is getting fixed. Whole bunch of good stuff happening today. Play that intro.
Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Those words have been dancing around my head all night. Oh, it's Vegas law, that phrase.
Kiana.
Fisher.
Choi.
Joe. Cards drawn are the past, ones to come are future.
And the best part? It's beatable.
Crickets, crickets.
I'm back. Yo, I'm sorry. The guys are literally coming any minute. I'm going to have to get up.
The boys are in town to fix the air conditioner.
Right.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's get it started. I hope that you guys are excited. My man Zunaid coming out of Vegas like he usually does. no, I don't even know where Zunaid's at. I just always say he's in Vegas. So how's the suite life, Zunaid?
Well, we'll see if we can afford it or not. Yesterday was not the greatest day in terms of trading. Well, in the morning it wasn't with you guys. So
it was bad for me too.
Yeah, we'll see if we can recover here in the morning session. The main ticker that I'm kind of taking a look at is going to be Coin. We talked about the $50 bounce and waiting for it. I'm already long 50, but that's in the morning, so I'm not going to worry about that. When it does come back and test 50 when the session actually starts, I will go ahead and look to go long. And I'll probably give it about 60 cents or so to the risk and see if we can go ahead and get it off at 50, 60, maybe even 50, 40, and then hopefully get some more at 50, 80s. But that's kind of what I'm keeping an eye on. Coinbase for sure, since we've been waiting for this one. And then let's take a look at NVIDIA. If this one wants to see more of a downside, again, 155, let me go ahead and set an alert. There is a trigger for me. And then, of course, it's going to be 150 as well if we ever get to that area. So I'm going to go ahead and set some alerts on that. And then for the Qs, don't really have anything in particular, maybe like the 287. But besides that, not something I really fancy in playing. We talked about the 290 level waiting for a scalp. And you can see you got yourself a couple of points at the 290 level there on the Qs. But we're well below that. So maybe the 280s would be the next level for me to go ahead and try to scalp some calls to the upside for like half a point, a point. Again, that's why it's a scalp. We are going to possibly go ahead and break below the 379 level. If we do, could go short there. Maybe around 376 would be your next target if that happens. But I'm not going to look to go short unless we truly break the 379. But again, I'm more interested in the other plays that I'd already pointed out. And Tesla is now below 700. You can see how it had a little bit of a tough time breaking up below it. Now it is. So for Tesla, you can go ahead and go short. Closer you get to 700, the better risk reward. I would probably give it about $6 if you're looking to go short. So 706 break to the upside, I would go ahead and cut my puts and call it an L. And then of course your first target would be about 695, and then you can go ahead and try to scale out more and more for every $5 that you get. But that's what I've got so far on all my tickers.
All right, let me go ahead and run through mine here real quick. We're going to first take a look at the movers tool here. It's worth mentioning ALNA is having a morning. Stock is 23 cents. I'm just not going to trade this today. This is not on my watch list. You're not going to hear me call this, but it is up. So if this is for you, keep that in mind. AKBA, same deal. Not even going to mess with it. Now, NXTP, same deal. A lot of these pennies, a lot of the junk seems to go. That really confirms that we're in a bear tape. We're in the middle of a bear market rally here, or we were. Anyway, TRVI, this one absolutely on deck today. This thing really needs to hold 250. 248 is the level that I've mentioned here. That candle wicked down to 246, but this 250 area really needs to hold. I want to see some movement through some of these levels. I want to see increased volume as always. Hopefully this is the one that works because we have a decent range already. And then if we snap 295, maybe we have a repeat of yesterday with AGRX. Maybe just have a big run, nice big trade there. Can F, this is another cannabis biopharma here. If this can hold one, this can move. The cannabis The cannabis sector has been massively beaten down, so I would expect a nice bounce on a relief rally. And it has a lot of, let's call it followers or fans. It's that type of industry that might be able to get a lot of eyeballs on it. So we'll see if that ends up materializing. And then NRSN, this is actually one from yesterday. This went ahead and popped again. So if we take a, if we zoom out and take another look at it, what's really interesting here is that we have a double top here at 329. This is your spot. This without a doubt is your spot. You might be able to trade leading up to that spot, but if we break above that spot, there's definitely going to be a trade on. I would think that even if this breaks and pulls, it would probably go back towards the high. The question is going to be, how much does it pull and how long does it take to get back to that high? Answers, I don't know yet. Another one here is going to be CBio. Again, this one is also in the cannabis industry. This one popped. It's leaking pretty good here, but as long as it holds 170, we should be in good shape. And I think that's it. Yeah, this was a penny bio. I want to check in on a couple from yesterday that moved just in case they get going again. EVFM looks like this is leaking. We're back below a dollar. Unsure if this is going to get moving again, but we'll keep it on the back burner. Same with AFib. This is back under a dollar. Again, back burner could get lit, especially if it gets volume. Yesterday, we had a trade early on AFib, but the volume really kind of dried up for the rest of the day. There were very few good opportunities. AXSM, which was another one from yesterday, that still looks like it's pushing towards the highs. And actually, to me, this chart looks like it wants higher. And if we take a look, let me move my drawing tools out of the way. If we take a look here at the daily chart, you can see that we've definitely got some room up here. So we're going to watch AXSM. The volume doesn't really seem to get moving there. But the big targets today out of the open, TRVI and NRSN. Those are going to be the two that I am watching. NRSI Gruguay, I'm probably butchering that. I'm sorry. NRSN going to the exercise price for insiders who lock up just expired. What is that price? Help us out here. What is that price? Rocky, if it's blurry, please adjust your setting in YouTube. That is a you issue, not an us issue. Please go to the gear cog in the bottom right corner of your YouTube stream and select source instead of auto so that you can see it. A little bit more clear.
Was there a level that you liked on NRSN? Sorry, I was just looking at the chart again.
Yes, the level is 329. Okay. 329. And so Gruguay is saying here, NRSN is going to the exercise price for insiders whose lockup just expired, which is $6. He's calling from a double from here. We'll see if that ends up working.
Yeah, I've got a high on Monday, I believe, of 330. And then obviously pre-market, we went ahead and hit that 329, I believe, that you might be talking about.
Yeah, 329, 330. It's the same.
Yeah, yeah. I'm just taking a little further look back and trying to see where I'd want to get in. I guess around $3 with a break of 290. Okay, cool. I'm just taking a look and seeing where VWAP is and all that.
Let me bring your screen up.
I was looking at Thinkorswim, but here, let me...
Get wrecked.
I know. So yeah, this is what I was taking a look at here, trying to find. So VWAP is around $3. So if you got a chance to take this around three, your stop loss, or at least my stop loss, would be a 290 break. So I'd be risking about 10, 11 cents. And then ultimately you can see trading on my laptop is always a disaster. You can see that this is an area of resistance, which is around 260. So if for some reason it comes down, it could possibly go in and test that area of breakout and then come back. So just something to keep in mind. No need to have FOMO. No need to break in and try to pay off the mortgage today. Try to hit some base hits and some singles, and we'll get there. Let's see if there's any other tickers.
Yeah, let's pull the chat. Guys, what tickers do you want us to take a look at? Boren suggested VET, which is Vermilion Energy. Looks like this. I don't really have a lean on. I'm skeptical on buying energy here as the momentum trade. Oil is higher today. Let's see if that has an effect on it. VET, as far as I'm looking at here, I'd really like it to clear out this formation here between 24. And then it might take a move towards the high here.
Just another example of how support becomes resistance and resistance becomes support. You can see right here that you had resistance at the 379s. Right here on the left-hand side on the 23rd and 24th. And then you had it earlier, the pre-market, that level held. So that's kind of your hold point. It's going to be the 379s in SPY for support. And then, of course, you've got resistance here at 382.02. So that's kind of an area that I'm keeping an eye on is 379. If we break that, we can see some more downside to the 376. And this is a 65-minute candle on SPY.
Real quick question here from Red or Green iBank. That's a nice handle. IWM thoughts. So IWM, what's interesting about the IWM is that we're already at the pre-pandemic level on the IWM. In fact, we're right there. I would expect a bounce here. I would actually expect a bounce through 180. I don't think that we'll actually make it back up to 200 because I think the market's still going to go lower as a whole. And I think that IWM will not be immune to that. But IWM definitely has come in more than the NASDAQ or the SPY. So if we take a look at the daily chart of the Qs here, you can see that we're still a ways away from that pre-market high. We're, what, 50 points?
Put your chart up.
Say again?
Put your chart up. Sorry, I don't have access right now.
I know. I got a lot going on this morning, Zunaid.
You're good. 238
here is going to be your high of the prior to COVID, and we still have quite a bit to come back in towards that, and I think we probably do. The story is the same on the SPY, right? So here we go. Pre-COVID high, pre-COVID level here is 338, currently at 381. So we have a lot of room to come back in here. This low, I think this low gets tested, and I think we break it to the downside. That's my call. I don't think we do that today, but I think we do that over the summer. Things are going to get worse before they get better, at least in my mind. Here's what I was trying to show earlier when I didn't have the right chart up. This is IWM is right at the pre-COVID level. So it actually broke beneath it. I would expect a bounce here. So those are my thoughts. I can't tell you where we're going to go next. I'm just going to play what is in front of me here.
Let's see if there's anything else. Actually, there's one more stock that actually came up on my scanner just now. HTGM. Have we covered that one?
Guys, I got to dip for a sec.
I'll be. All right, no worries. HCGM. The reason I like this one is because it's around a dollar. And you guys know I love my whole numbers. We played that with EVSM many times. This one looks like you've got a high of yesterday of around 111. Let me put this one on my trading view and not my thinkorswim because you guys can't see that. And that's not going to work. HTGM. There it is. You can see this one's around a dollar. You can see that you had a high of about 111 yesterday's session. I'm trying to find where the best support would be. And so far, I am seeing it at 80 cents. Now, we'll see if this dollar holds or not. But for now, it's acting as a little bit of resistance. You've got a break here of about 102s. So if this one comes down to 80 cents, and if this is your type of stock that you like to play, 80 cents would be kind of the risk reward. So the closer you get it to 80 cents, the better risk reward you'll have, in my opinion. Might not be a stock that I'll play personally, but if this is something that fits your appetite and your risk tolerance, so keep an eye on this one. That is HTGM. Mitch, did you have any stocks you want to go over?
Yeah, let's go ahead and I'll dive on in here. Let's take a look at the overall market right here. Right off the back, I did see IWM thoughts. You guys covered IWM, right?
I believe Ryan went through it, but give your levels. Different insights, always great.
Yeah, always. So yesterday, what did I talk about? What would get me bearish again, right? Was a close below 383. That's exactly what we had. I didn't expect we'd get there yesterday. I talked about it that, at least in my eyes, I wasn't looking for us to get all the way down there. I actually thought we had a little bit more room to the upside run. Doesn't mean it can't come in today, right? And so I think what you watch today, at least in my eyes, I'm going to watch that same level. That 383.90, or if you look at it, it's this high right here from June 15th. That's why I'm watching that level. Yesterday, we did finally close up through the gap right on the SPY, right? And now we're going to look to see what happens today. Do we just get a ramp right through yesterday's high? That could happen. One of the things that I talked about yesterday before the open is that sometimes the market likes to pressure the bulls and the bears. A lot of the times when the stocks are trending in one way, it's kind of like pressuring one side, right? But when you get this kind of choppiness action on the daily, really what happens here is that it pressures both sides, especially the day traders. It's pressuring the shorts right out the gates. We saw yesterday what a lot of spikes, right? These kind of like bull trap charts. And what ended up happening is they came back down through the VWAP, through the support, and never stopped. And so this is when you go ahead and you pressure the opposite side. And so now what happens is, what? How's everybody coming in, kind of coming into the market? And they're feeling like these 363s or the lows here from June 17th looks like a target on the downside. And so now we might have some more people lean into the short side, bulls giving up. And then what happens? We could have a rally. This is a lot of the times the way that the market kind of works around the psychology of the market. And this is why some people will say things like, you know, you'll see some traders say like things don't matter outside of this. The only thing I want to focus is kind of like the charts itself and the price action that I see at the open, being more in a reactionary mindset than being kind of in tune with the markets overall. You see that a lot from Zunaid. I know that probably Zunaid could talk a little bit more about why he feels that way, but I see that sometimes being a benefit in moments like this, especially because we're seeing that choppy action. And if you get lean in with your bias, a lot of times what ends up happening is, boom, you have that objectiveness that you're just looking one way. And when things go against the way that we think things are going to go, a lot of times our tendencies inside our mind is to think, well, no, this shouldn't happen, or this isn't logical, or let me actually trade against this. Not the way we want to be reacting. We want to be reactionary to the market, especially as day traders. As swing traders, you can be a little bit more trend leaning. And I think this is an important thing also to think about. But when we're day traders, what are we? We're trading that day, the intraday momentum, sometimes as quick as like 10 minutes for Zunaid, right? And so that just shows us that in those times of moments, we need to be more focused on what's happening in front of us versus all the noise outside in the markets. All right, I hope you guys enjoyed that. That was just a little bit more of kind of an insight from, you know, seeing this action from both sides, swing traders as being a day trader, as being also an investor. As investors are going to continue watching and talking about the Fed and what's happening out there, we can focus more on the intraday action and see what happens today. All right, so I do have the swing trade on. Yesterday I did get back into ExxonMobil. I did get stopped out, guys, but I did go back into it at 91 when we finally started to recover. This is what I've been seeing more and more of, where the stocks like to come back here towards the 1 hour support line. And we talked about this yesterday. So once it started coming back into that line, that's when I jumped into it right around here on the 91. So I'm still long on the swing trade of ExxonMobil from 91. I'm going to look for a little breakout above 93s to take some off and let this continue working. I'm looking to add to this position, which is something that I'm trying to continue working on. So taking some profit, using that same profit to add back to the stock. This is where we're going to start trying to keep working more and more of going back to swing trading. This is one thing that I think I need to do to also just get back into what is my bread and butter. The only time that I've been, you know, decently profit, there's one thing I would say decently where you can actually call it kind of some true income. That's been when I just focus on swing trading. Day trading, I usually end up usually either slightly green or near the break even. So in that case, I think it's not a long-term success roadmap for me. So you guys will see me take more and more swing trades. They're smaller size, so that's one thing to keep in mind. When you take swing trades, you want to give yourself an ability to get around the intraday volatility and make sure that you're able to do that, that you're not just getting stopped out on up and down moves, that you're getting in on longer term supports using charts like an hourly or 15 minute to target those lows and then catch that swing back on up. So that's what I'm going to go back to, which is my bread and butter, which is really where I could show a consistent track of that good profitability. So let's go into that. Let's focus on that. Today, what we're going to take a look at is technology, right? Technology has really taken a hit recently, and we're starting to see this pullback. Now the real question is, do some of these names just start giving up the gains and continuing that, right? And so we did get really bad news in AMD yesterday. It's flushed down, though. And so this is one that I actually could see bouncing back a little bit today, talking about how we could get that ramp back, right? Everyone's looking bearish. I'm actually going to look at the bell to watch what happens, because we could all of a sudden just get a rip. And if we do get a rip up in technology, I'd be looking at a stock that's beaten down like AMD to maybe catch some of that sympathy right back up. And of course, selling into that if you're doing that kind of day trade here. So it's not like I'm not going to take day trades, but if I do take them, they're going to be smaller sizing just to kind of knock in, knock out, kind of practice the strategies there. But the main focus is going to go to swing trading. And I think we're going to watch also BTU today. Of course, our coal player did come back yesterday, but what in the after hours? So let's see if it takes out the highs here and we get through 25 today. If we do get through 25, this is going to be one to take a look for a swing trade also up there with a push towards 27.35. That's where I could see us going and move back up towards this resistance and then taking profits somewhere into that move. We'll keep watch, BTU. What you watching, Zunaid?
I'm trying to figure out, man. This Coinbase is kind of tripping me up because I want to go ahead and get some more here at 50.34. I'm already sold some at the 50.50. Hmm. Yeah. But I'm probably just going to wait till the market opens and see where that's, I mean, unfortunately I haven't hooked up. I forgot my HDMI. I don't feel like messing with this hotel TV. So I'm strictly working one screen. And so my only focus at the moment is going to be Coinbase. I have an order out to buy some at 50.09, and I'll let you guys know if I go ahead and get filled. And there it goes. I just went in and got filled 50.09. My stop loss is going to be the break of 49.50s. So I'm going to go ahead and try to sell some. Let me see. I'll put my sell order in at the 38s. 38s. 50.38. I'm looking to get out on Coinbase.
All right. Going to take a look here to XOM right out the gates to see what's going on here. We're just breaking through that 93 level. Going to go ahead and take some profit into this move. If we can get above the here, let's see if we can get toward the little push above the 93s here.
Yeah, you had coin kind of go up and test the 20s as well. So you were in the money by about 10 cents or so. But again, 38 is where I'm looking to get out on Coinbase. It might dip a little bit below 50s here. That's okay with me. Again, 59.50 crack is where I'm going to go and get out. I'm risking about 50 bucks or so per 100 shares on this one. And there's a crack below 50. Not the best sign. So I'm going to go ahead and grab some more here. Got filled at 49.70.
Just sold half there, 93.03s.
My average price is 49.91s.
All right. So where can we look for our ad today in XOM? It's going to be a level that needs to come back here towards 92. So it'd have to go below 92 for me to take an attempt off of that. So I'll let you guys know if I do get an attempt alert there on 92. I'm going to set the alert. And if not, just let XOM work. Maybe even take a day trade on some other oil names, but you don't want to be too heavily leveraged in one area.
I'm taking a little bit more of a risk. I'm going to try to sell some of the ones that I added. Instead of trying to sell into the 50s, I'm going to look to sell at 50.12. But let's see if I even get that opportunity on coin.
All right. NXTP being mentioned in the chat. All right. So I see you guys. This is pulling back there. We'll see if that gets back. No movement just yet.
HTGM. I'm going to take a small size here. I got filled at 113. Looking for it to hold the 90s. If it doesn't, I will go ahead and get out on HTGM. All right. Coinbase is well below that. I'm going to go ahead and get out.
What? Is your mom telling you to go to sleep?
Probably, but you know me, I stayed up when I was in middle school. I'm gonna stay up now that I'm out of school.
Hell yeah, man. Were you one of those kids that let your mom like walk down the hallway and then turn the TV back on?
Oh, 100%. 100%.
Hell yeah.
Had bought wireless headphones. That way I could go ahead and watch TV and play video games well. But anyway, I'm gonna go and take an L on this one. Ooh, got out here at 49.40s. I am out. I took an L. And now my sole focus is on this HTGM trade. Let me go
spy
ahead.
Spy coming down there to 389. We popped for a second. Now coming right back down. Where are we going to get concerned is the low here. The low is 379.45. If we crush through that, That's the level that we got to start watching for continued downside action there. Tesla coming on down there. Tesla broke 50 points yesterday, guys, and now it's down to 682s. I think this eventually could even get down there to 500. 600 is definitely in reach. It has a bear pattern right here. Multiple times that you're seeing here, Tesla reject this kind of, we'll call it a bear pennant here. Two times on the bottom. Now you're seeing that top hold there. It really looks negative underneath 700 here.
HTGM, the dollar held. So if you went with the game plan we talked about earlier, you're up about 20 cents in the money. Right now, 120 seems to be the area of resistance on this one. I'm going to go ahead and put a little box there. Hopefully we can break above that. But HCGM 120 is a session high. My average fill is a crappy one, which is 115, unfortunately. But I'm looking for like 130s, 150s on this one. So I'm going to hold out, not sell just yet. VWAP is close to about 106, 107s. And, of course, a dollar is your hold number point, if you will, on HTGM. NXTP, I'll take a look at that. Let's see, NXTP. I know that was the other one that we reviewed. Oh, nope, that one was not the one that we reviewed because it was not that cheap. What do we look at here? Unless I looked at the wrong ticker. Again, working off of one screen, so bear with me. Yeah, NXTP, I'm not really sure I see anything. Let me go back to HGTX. What was the ticker? HTGM. All right, let's see. Still waiting for that 120 break. We've got our boxes all right, set up.
Put some bounce backs out there. Definitely some downside action to start off here. Yeah, real estate getting pounded.
120 break.
Technology getting pounded.
If HCGM wants
to 78.
To come down to 110s, I'd be interested. No, you're good, dude. HCGM, if it wants to come down to 110 on 10s, I would go ahead and grab some more. No problemo. No problemo. Yeah, 110 is near VWAP too. I'm perfectly okay with it. Cool. I've got an order out to buy some more at 110 if it wants to come on down.
Utilities and defensives doing well right now, guys. What is doing well in defensive names? Grocery stores, food distribution. We see grocery stores. There's really not much. KR is up about 2% there, but I don't see too much on that. I don't want to go after there. So taking a look for some other trades.
Got filled that HCGM. My average price is now 112.50. So we'll just call it 113 to round that down. Or excuse me. 113 to round it up on HTGM. What I'm going to try to do is the shares that I just grabbed, I'm going to try to sell those at 18s, 118s if I can.
Definitely a pullback here in overall stocks. Defensives are the only thing that have up, but there's not much up there. So we'll see if when we get a swing or not, but everything's pointing to the downside right now. Even utilities are up, but they're not, it's only 0.6 from the open. I'm trying to see if there's anything that's kind of giving me a signal there, but there's not much right now.
All right, here we go. Went ahead and took some profits here at 118 on HTGM. The fills were 110. We got out at 118. That's a solid 8 cents on a dollar stock. That's close to about 6% or so if my sleepy brain can do the math. And now we're still waiting for that. We're still waiting for that 120 break on the initial purchase.
Yo, 21131. I don't know which what numbers there were. You did get put in timeout for just mentioning NXTP way too much. The stock's going down. You're talking about value to the upside. We're not going to have spam in the chat.
And there's the upside that you brought up. Come on. I went ahead and hit a high about 122, and we're trying to go and break above it and hold above it on HTGM. There it is, 123s, 124s.
That's actually a good idea, Keith.
Pulling out a little bit.
Man, be careful with that scaling out. Zunaid, you were sounding like a robot there on the internet Wi-Fi there for a second.
How about now? Am I good?
You're good. You're good. I just want to keep that in mind so you don't lose internet also. But man, got to get out of trades.
Yeah. That's why exactly why I've kind of got my phone right here, because I know how this hotel Wi-Fi trading stuff works. Matter of fact, I wanted to get out at 123. But so thinkorswim has this damn weird thing where it's like, oh, you have to get out at like to the 10 digits. So it's like you have to get out at 125. You can't get out at 125.44. But it's like the active trader has 125.44. So like, stop being dumb. Anyway, first world problems.
Yeah, that's the fractional shares. When they give you a better fill price, you're unable to actually exit at that price. Yeah. TRVI, by the way, it's, one we talked about. Sorry, go ahead.
Did you fill me with an average? You're fine. And this is what I wanted to scale out. Now we're right back at 113, and that's fine. Whatever. I don't like you anyway.
All right, TRVI trying to bust 272 here. There it goes. Here we go. 275 up. Some size there. If we take that, we go higher. 272, 275 seem to be the spot so far this morning. They took 272 twice. They've made an attempt at 275. Here's attempt two. Not yet. It definitely wants higher here, TRVI.
Looking for some consolidation here in XOM. I'm trying to see if we can go towards the 91.50s here. If not, I'm going to probably take an ad here. This is still the swing trade. Still good in the position. Took some really good profit out the gates here on this one. I'm looking for the ad now on the pullback.
$110 still holding on HCGM.
Order out to grab it at 50s here. The ad. Just got the ad there. 91.50s on XOM. We're going to hold towards the hourly support underneath that. That's going to be a move towards 90.54. It's our risk. We just added
TRVI
there.
XOM. Through.
Boom.
Gonna trim some here. Whew. Busy morning. Higher now?
Yeah, you got me money to pay that AC.
Now my average is 91.08, guys. So we'll see if
that out TRVI here. Up. Sorry, Mitch.
No, you're good. We're all just giving our positions.
Okay, one.
Apple looks to bounce off the VWAP. Okay. How's the SPY doing here? I spy with my little eyes. We're down there through the low of kind of the pre-market action, now down to 378. Definitely seeing that continued downside. Will we find a bounce or do we kind of close on up here towards, what do we got here? What's this body? 378.06. Okay. But we could possibly see some bounce. Let's see. I got some nice bounce in Exxon there. I did get in there at the 91.50 level. The low of the day is 91.46. So not too bad there on that little bounce there, Phil. Just filled about, sold half and I bought a quarter back there. So the average cost is only up there towards 91.08. So not going to stress too much about that. That's a nice little dip buy there.
Spy to the downside. Yep. Went ahead and dropped a couple of points. Now it's at that 879 level that we had kind of talked about earlier. Let's see if it kind of holds the support or if it goes ahead and cracks. But I'm only focused on one stock and one stock only, and that's going to be HTGM.
For some shorts out there. We're going to see anything, but right around this time is where we like to get reversals, so it's kind of hard to get into it. I did see the SPY kind of put in a little candle here, so I'm going to give the SPY a little bit of a chance to see if we start pushing back up here.
Hope they're able to fix that AC, man, and not have to go and get parts and come back and all of that.
They are here to replace the entire unit. They will be here most of the day. It will be fixed today. It'll be a brand new AC and furnace unit. And that could not come at a better time. It's going to be hot today. It's going to be 95 and humid tomorrow.
Wow. Yikes.
Woo-hoo.
I've never experienced this. I've never gone through something like this in my entire life. A massive heat wave that lasts multiple weeks where I have no AC other than this portable unit that is literally running 24/7.
All right. Great. Sark anyway, looking good
about
here.
Let's talk about the market.
Sark looking good here, guys. If you guys want to take, I might take a little scalp here.
Oh,
I just missed that buy there. Having it there at 93s there. 62.93 is doing a little bit of a scalp trade here on Sark. Let's see if we can get through 63s here. There's 63s. Sorry that I'm not putting the little kind of bar there. I'm just trying to focus on it. Looking like I want to do a little bit of a pullback there. Yeah, I got, I'm sorry. I didn't click on it here. Sark, guys. Took a little bit of a starter there. Got caught up here in the 90s here. Looking for a push through 63 here. Want to see the 90 EMA hold. You can see how it's been holding on the pullbacks, making sure that holds so the low of 62.60 would get me out. Looking for the push through 63 and taking out this high 63.20s.
CBIO through the highs here. 183 was that high.
I'm going to give it a second here.
Oh, God damn NVIDIA to the downside. Holy smokes.
There's 6305s on the bid. Ah, it doesn't want to hold up there in the 63s. Getting out there. Just got out there, guys. Won like 2 cents on it. Just wasn't giving me that kind of breakout. And when I try to, if I ever buy near the highs of the day, I want to see instant gratification. Just got out there. You can see it now. Now it's getting that move. Hey, sometimes sell a little bit early, but was looking for maybe a pullback to VWAP here. And I would rather like that entry. So just got
guys,
in there. Got out there.
Getting jiggy.
Didn't look too bad though. So it'd been a good one to watch right at the gates when we saw the SPY dropping, ARKK continuing that downside action. You can watch this one also with Sark to see the opposite, right? Hood coming down there, Roku coming down there. So these are all kind of interesting names here. Zoom continuing the downside action. Roblox, I know that one's been strong lately. This one looks like a good short here. Just want to see it push back towards maybe 34 here, reject 34 one more time. Then we could get on it.
Got the Qs crossing the 280s, and I would not be surprised if NVIDIA sees that 150 real quick.
There you go. Quantum SPY puts are up 50% this morning. There you go.
B hat looks like it wants to test 3 here.
Yeah, that time of reversals comes often, Keith. It's crazy around that 9:45, 10 a.m., how often you get those kind of just swings back. A lot of that being kind of the first 15 minutes of the day, there's a trade called the opening range breakout. That's 3 5-minute candles and then determining where it's going, right? And then so you get a lot of patterns that kind of come play into that, and that's why we get that often.
All right, now you're looking at a break of 120s again on HTGM. Come on. We already hit a high of 124s, so that's another resistance, but we know 120 is as well. Come on. There's 120, there's 122, and now 124 comes into play if it doesn't get yanked. Let me go to the 10-minute here. Yep, there we go. Come on.
Watching Roblox come up back through the 34s. Let's take a look at the SPY, see what we're seeing there. Want to make sure that we're not just getting a big rip right back.
Here we go. I've got a sell order right at 124. I should probably stop being greedy and take it at 123. Doesn't matter. 124 just went in and got filled on half my size. Still waiting for the rest to possibly get to about the 130s or so. 124, though, out half size on HTGM. That's the second leg that we've been profitable with. We added some at 110, took it out at 118, and we added at 115 and took it out here at 124. We had
three tests. Break a three here, I think, pops B-hat. There it goes.
B-hat.
There we go.
You can put your chart up.
What? Gotcha.
Click your chart. Click your chart. Click the chart. Click the chart. I like the daily chart on that three breakout. So doesn't look too bad there. How's the volume looking? I don't know what B-hat does necessarily, but.
Yeah, I don't know what this company does either.
Yeah. Let's go, B-hat. Let's go 305. Ask now. 307. Here we go. We caught one, boys.
Nice.
Yeah, this is also a daily breakout, so I think this is a really good looking chart there, Ryan.
Yeah, there's definitely a lot of room here.
I'll show you guys that.
That's going to happen, but there's a lot of room. 310 is where it stopped at. It looks to test that again here pretty soon.
So you see right here, this is a daily breakout. It could get up there, at least in my eyes, towards 344s today. Hourly chart's going to help you too. Look at the hourly chart. Look how clean this looks on the hourly. This is what I like to see when the stock pops sideways action on the hourly, and then you pop right back through that level. 267, I'd also look for pullbacks maybe towards 278s, but definitely after that three today, what did you get? 280s, it pops 278s, pulls back, then gives you that rally. That's why you can use that hourly chart often. All right, short here on Roblox. Just going to hold towards 34. Got short there at 33.94. That's on the right-hand side here, guys. Short there off the rejection. I talked about it probably about 5 minutes ago. I said looking for a rejection, another rejection off 34 for Roblox, and then we're going to look to take it down. B-hat there. B-hatted.
All right, there's a winner. There we go.
Nice trade, pal.
There we go. Jessica, I really appreciate all of the support you're trying to drum up for us. That means a lot. Hey, guys, can the other 400 people hit the like button? It's literally free. Just hit the like button. It helps us do this for free.
Slightly caress it.
Keith agrees. Thank you, friends.
Slightly caress it. You ain't got to be aggressive with that. Just slightly. Nice little touch.
Oh, B-hat. All right. So B-hat might be in play here the rest of the day. We'll see if it sets up. I wanted to book some profit here, so...
Was not that's watching my trade there. Just got squeezed out hard in Roblox there. Damn, was not even watching. Definitely let it run 20 cents higher there. Was not even watching, was trying to get the screen up. My fault.
Chris, nice job on Apple and Microsoft. I saw you were talking about that this morning, but I was back and forth and didn't catch the thesis. So nice trade, though. I'm assuming that you're probably in the short-dated calls in both of those names. Daniel Watson, nice job on B-hat. Nice job, bro. Put that money in your pocket.
HCGM hit a high of about 128. Again, I was waiting for 130, so I did not scale out for the third time. Still hanging tight. You've got VWAP around 115. I'm probably done adding on this one. Made some solid money. Traded from the hotel. I do not want to go ahead and mess around and give it back. So I'm going to hang tight here, and someone just scheduled a call for 2 p.m. Sorry, I just got an email.
HTGM, did you play enough VWAP pull, Zunaid?
I played it when I bought them at 110. I played it off of the VWAP, yes.
Yep, nice job. That's textbook. So this is the – I missed Zunaid's trade. I knew that he was in it, and when I flipped over to it, I saw all of these candles wicking to the VWAP on the one-minute chart and figured, you know what? That's exactly where Zunaid played it. I Who's sure having did. Errors with Thinkorswim?
That would be me. That would be me.
Good, it's bro?
Yeah, it's the damn – you can't have, like, multiple decimals nonsense.
Yeah.
Huh. Yeah, it's like, oh, price action rejected, decimal form, blah, blah, whatever.
No fill there on Tesla there. I was trying
to
get to
the highs. Remember, we talked about this yesterday. Sorry, Mitch.
No, you're good. Tesla looking good here to the upside because it's been beaten down. Tried to get in there. Didn't get the fill there. It's to see if I can get it on the pullback again.
I Anyone know why PayPal is trading up?
No idea.
I do not. Let's see. I'll take a look at the price levels. So let's see. PYPL. If you're looking to go long, you've got resistance at previous close at 72, which also happens to be a little bit of resistance at the pre-market level. If you want to go short, break at 70 is your buddy there to the downside on PayPal from the quick glance that I've got on the 10-minute here.
Liking Chevron right now. I'm going to give it a chance here to get back above the VWAP.
Monster move here on PayPal. PayPal moved $2 off the lows here and on volume too. So interesting. I don't see any news. I'll see if I can find anything on the Twitter streets.
Look at how well VWAP was held on HTGM once again on the third 10-minute candle here at the 116s. I like it, man. Go ahead. You got it.
Long CVX Chevron. Long Chevron here, guys. Want to see it get back above VWAP and hold that. This is our candle of our outside. That's 150s, 57s. We got there 80s. Yeah, 150, 81.
Oh.
Let's see if a little drive in oil. Another thing you can watch is Gush. Want to see Gush kind of do that bottoming action and just start pushing towards the upside. So you can see Gush here looking interesting also for a nice reversal type of play. I'm looking for more reversals in this type of market.
Looks like there was an activist note on PayPal, activists sniffing around PayPal. So looks like some activists like the price drop in PayPal, and maybe that's what's going on here. That looks like that popped it. I'm not going to chase this here, though. This is not a strong enough catalyst for me to just go chasing.
You've got shop after the split as well, by the way, around $34 now. And then our good old UPST trading at $33 after.
Oh, Jim Cramer talked about PayPal. I'm sorry. I missed that. Thank you, Brenda.
UPST from 400 to 33. God bless. Wow. 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 That's insane.
Let's see if we can get above 151 on Chevron. That's going to be a nice close on a 3-minute candle there for Chevron to start getting back above. Looking at the sector overall, seeing some bottoming action. Let's see if we can start getting it to ride on up. That's energy. So we'll see what happens here. How's our SPY doing here? SPY came back up towards kind of like the open there, now pulling back below the open. We'll see if this can hold VWAP.
All right, got some more drawings on HCGM there. Let's see if the drawings hold our levels.
There's a nice push in Chevron. Let's see if it can hold this 151 now. Looking at PSX, looking at that one that was mentioned in the chat. That one also looks like a nice bottoming play there. Chevron starting to get that little lift. Let's see if we can get that continuation. We got in on this pullback. Well, you call it a throwback. Now you're looking for the push back towards the open. Opening price was at 151.48. That's kind of where we're going to pay attention to see what happens and see if we can get the push into 152. We want to see it close below VWAP now. Yeah, they all kind of move hand in hand, right? When you're trying to look at these oil names. That's why sometimes I look what's called the leader and laggard play. Look for something to lead and then look for a laggard that's maybe off of a reversal support if you're going long, or the opposite way for a short. You see, we're pulling back here and still fighting the VWAP right now.
IMTE looks like this is trying to challenge highs of the day. An IMTE.
I'm hoping for a little bit of bull flag on this HTGM on the 5 minute.
Trying to see a close back above 151 here for Chevron. It's testing here. Might have to just get on out here. Just going to give it a second here. I'll let you know if I get out. There's a recovery. Another thing to kind of watch is Gush. If it takes out the lows, you would be a little bit careful there. And you can see how it rejected VWAP. Don't trade the chops, says Red Rum.
You've got an 8-ball request, Ryan.
Okay, what is it?
Can you? Hey, Ryan. There you go. You got it.
Okay, do you mean square SQ or do you mean the SQQQ? That's what I need clarification on.
No, that's a good one. Can't have the 8-ball. Can't try to trick the 8-ball now.
The 8-ball knows. All right.
Sorry, I'm stuck in a bad trade. I'm bag holding IMTE here on this nasty, nasty pull. Okay, SQQQ. All right, let me try to do that here. If you hear me shriek, it's because I got absolutely destroyed by IMTE. What's the question here? Will the SQQQs go up today? Let's see. Can I get full screen, Mitch? Can you help me out here?
Yeah, I got you. I just had to get out of Chevron. Didn't want to get caught like last time.
I'm still in my trade. Come on.
That was a little bit of a rug on energy. What's he say?
Better not tell you now. Sorry, Jessica. We're going to have to wait.
Terrible. Terrible, terrible, terrible.
Sorry. That's always the worst. Come on, IMT. This is ridiculous. Okay, get me off full screen.
No? You don't want to stay on there?
No. We'll ask it again, Jessica. Don't worry.
All right. Well, it's my swing trade keeping me in the green. Day trading not going so well today, but hey, small size. Hasn't been much. Roadbox was the one that we let go a little bit too much.
Hey, whoa. Come on, HG.
Ryan is a little pressed. Ryan is managing a bad trade right now and trying to get out of it. That's all.
And in the hot weather too. That ain't easy.
Yep. No, I'm telling you, man, it just makes you go crazy. It's awful. It is the absolute worst thing ever.
Tesla, interesting here. Putting out an order on Tesla long, trying to get it filled. I'll let you guys know if I do get it.
130s on HTGM. Hope you guys are scaling out. Yes, sir.
Ha. Put out an order of maybe a little bit too below Tesla. Now it's already breaking through the highs there. It was a good, nice setup there. I put out the order about 20 cents below. It was looking for a little pop fill, but missed the breakout there on Tesla, guys. Ha, a little annoyed there. It was holding right here. It held back towards this low. I could see it here on the 3 minutes. It had a nice consolidation. I was trying to get in right here around 160, 681, 80s. And then it went right through 682s and didn't stop. Now it's up there to 687. I'll look for it to get through the 690s first. and then try to make a pull back to VWAP. But does look good here, testing towards the upside. You want to see SPY maybe taking off there. Strong candle there on the SPY. So it looks good there for Tesla. Apple really strong right now. Looks like we might get a little upside lift here. AMD is the one I'm going to go after here because I see it right off the VWAP. I'm going to take a little bit of a starter here, looking for a little bit of a pullback, but it might just take off without me here. So trying to get a little bit here. We'll let you guys know if I'm able to grab it before 79 here. Let's see a pullback coming in here. Can we get back there towards 78.50?
God damn it, man.
See if we can get this pullback. It's not coming in there. Looking for it now. It just broke through 79. I hope some people, looked like they got trapped there. They were starting to hit the offer side there. Looking for the pullback to 78.50 here. Can we get it? Little pullback, baby. Little pullback. Right into this area. 56, 50s. Let's go. Trying not to extend myself here. I like this one because it's beaten down and you're seeing the SPY push up a little bit.
IMTE coming back on here. Watch 369 if we get up there.
Gosh, kind of tricked me there. I'm okay with it. I still got some exposure to oil today. SPY, let's put the SPY here. Qs, we're looking at more tech right now. Yeah, it does look strong there. Looking for this pullback. Here it is, 74s. Into the 60s and the 50s here. Just trying to hold 75s. There's the cut through. Come on. There's the pullback.
Pulling IMTE off flat here. It was down like 150 bucks. I got out minus $15. I'm happy with that. Got my bad trade back. We'll watch if this breaks above 369. Careful, you might want to add on the pulls on IMTE. Okay, let me get back to the eight ball. Let me try that one more time. Holy smoke. Sorry, I was doing so much there.
Put yourself full screen if you're going to do that for me.
Yeah, I will. Maybe Zunaid and his can have a battle of the eight balls. Oh no, battle of the eight balls.
Mine's in the suitcase. I gotta get mine. Well,
if you're in the suitcase, you already lost. So that's how it goes. All right, here we go. Both the SQQQs.
Starter.
We asked the eight ball to see, are the SQQQs going to go up today? You told us ask again. Give us an answer.
For a little pullback more in AMD, but I did take a starter there.
Outlook good, Jess. Outlook good.
Nice.
Outlook good. So looks like the SQQQs are going up today per the eight ball. I'm gonna get myself off
the screen. SQQQQs.
Three Qs.
I don't like you, Abel.
Yeah, Z Digital. I'm good. I'm out now. I can actually wait for a better setup. And now that I've seen that actually happen, I should be able to get a smarter entry. I'll kind of wait for it to pull back instead of feeling FOMO and trying to hit the breakout.
Hey Ryan, watch those top wicks on that 5-minute chart.
He's right. This is Z Digital. This is actually really good. This is a really good observation. Eight ball has spoken.
All right, just added there here on AMD. Oh.
Something to kind of keep in mind here. You take a look at HTGM. This is why, in my opinion, it's so important to have limit orders already out there in terms of where you want to get in, where you want to get out. Because, I mean, look at this. In 1 minute, you hit 130s and then came right back down to 116s. That's a 15-cent drop. If you want to put my chart up, Mitch or Ryan.
I forgot you're in as a guest today, my friend.
Yep.
You're guessing it.
All right, you can see it here on this candle at 10:03. 130, 115. I mean, that's just such a move where you want to make sure you have your limits already set, your stop loss is already set, so you can take profits as needed. And there's HTGM coming down, cracking below VWAP. So know your entry, know your stop loss, know your profit taking, and have your limits already out there.
All right. So in this AMD at 7862 average now. Let's see if we can really get this to start pushing. The Qs, I want to see that push up. I want to see the SPY push up. So you guys see the SPY on my left-hand side, the Qs right here. Let's see if the Qs can take it, this high out, the SPY come back to the highs. That's what we're going to look for. And also AMD get a strong candle in here. Going to give a nice bullish engulfing look. Let's see if we get that. Chasey Chase wants the AMD 8-ball. I don't know if I want to do that just yet. I might have to change my opinion there. Got to keep those spreads tight. Kind of muted, my friend.
Yeah, 285s. You've got resistance here on the Qs is what I'm kind of taking a look at. I said I wouldn't trade more than one ticker, but kind of interested in going short the Qs versus high of day being risk off. But I'll let you guys know if I decided to actually pull the trigger on it.
Getting tested real quick here. Tough market, man. Tough market. Needs a bounce off the VWAP here. It's 7830s. Let's see it get back above and close. Make sure that it closes above that 7830s here.
You know what I wish I had right now would be like an adjustable base. Because I'm trading from my bed. I don't feel like going to the desk.
My man said, I'm too used to my adjustable base, hey, baby. Man.
It is such a... I mean, that's one of the best things you can do.
Game changer. Let them really know. Is. Let them know, guys.
It really is. I would rather have an adjustable base than a solid mattress.
Damn.
Yep.
Shout out for the mattress. Forget the mattress. Get that adjustable base.
100%.
Oh, just got
to trying to break over 228 here. Needs volume to do it, though.
Not going to do it here. Give it a second here. Is it going to break 78? AMD is just doesn't want to hold there.
Amazon's been rocking and rolling, too.
Yeah, a little recovery there. See if we get a recovery candle and test the 78.
Hey, John, trying to take 28 here. There's a bid right under it, and there's some decent volume prints here at 228. Needs really – they're up. They took it. Here we go. Let's see if we can – looks like – let me see if we can get a spot on the daily on this because this is going here. Looks like the next spot on the daily is 233. We're at 229. So this might be a little bit of a grinder here, but AGEN, A-G-E-N, Alpha Golf, Echo November.
Holy Ryan.
What?
I just said Holy Ryan.
Holy? No. You got that wrong, Mitch.
Aw, you saint. I'm going to go ahead and try. Go ahead.
They were clearing out 229 on AGEN. Sorry, go ahead.
I'm going to go short here. Amazon got filled at 110.87s. Stop loss would be 111.05.
The Qs and the SPY choppy here. Keeping a close eye on that. They did put a little push in there. They're holding the supports right now. Question is it come back to VWAP or break through the highs?
I'm going to try to go ahead and take some in the 50s. I was in the money by 20 cents, but I didn't feel like taking it. Could get stopped out quite easily, but it is a game that we play.
Nice recovery of 78s there. Q's trying to push back to the highs. SPY trying to push to the highs. Let's see if we get a push here, a continued push. Possible head and shoulders on SPY 5 minutes at Quantum. Let me see that.
Why are there options expiring tomorrow? Some, like I think SPY and other, SPY expires Monday, Wednesday, week? Friday. And then you've also got, I think there were some that were working on daily expirations on the SPY and the Qs. I'll be honest, I'm not by my normal setup, so I can't really look it up for you. But
ugly turn there, guys. Just need to see a quick recovery of that. We're getting out.
Amazon short, going to go ahead and cover everything right here. Money in the bank. Covered everything at, what's my notification say? 110.39, out everything on Amazon. Sure. Quick little short. Thank you. Thank you.
You short the high pop there?
I sure did. I was short at the 80s, 110.80s. And the
out there, guys. Out there at the 85 mark.
Hey, buddy.
Figure loss there on AMD. Took a little bit more of a swing there.
Look at, but he doesn't want, he's so shy. What are you doing?
He hears the people working. Q's SPY rejecting to break out through the highs there. Hard downside action there. AMD. Definitely a little bit of a loss there. Looks like AMD not trying to recover today.
Yeah, it's just chopping up that VWAP. If you're looking to go short, the closer you get it to 78, the better. Stop loss would be a break of 78.50 to the upside.
That's how he says hi, Aaron. That's how cats say hi. Just so you know.
I have so many things to say to that.
Bet you do, Zunaid. ADTH up towards highs here. Day high here. It looks like 294. That's going to be your spot here. Still in AGEN waiting for a 228 break. Where are you going? Where are you going? You're going to lay on the desk, aren't you?
Hendrix just fell asleep on this market. I feel like I should do the same.
Amen. That's why I'm in bed. I'm literally like, you know what? I'm not trading from the desk. I'm just going to trade from here. I don't need two screens. Amazon short. If you're still in it, make sure you scale out. It went ahead and gave you 80 cents. Went ahead and tapped 110s.
Where is my mouse?
The cat ate it.
Cat out the bag. Oil coming down, SPY coming down, Q's coming down. Everything is coming down.
Ryan is asking, what do you think of Michael Burry's recent comments? I'm assuming what you're referring to is the comments he made about the market having plenty of room to plunge. I would ask where he put the microphone in my place, because I've been saying that for a long time. I have actually given some more specific levels. I'm thinking 340, 350 handle on the SPY is probably where we finish. And I've also been saying that what I really want to see is the capitulation flush. We talked yesterday about on Happy Hour, about a new term that some experienced traders have used, the fill your diaper trade, right? So until your diaper is full, we can't really have a change in sentiment. So what they're effectively saying is when you get really scared, when everyone hits the sell button and moves out of the way, that's when we can turn around. I think that's probably what Burry's referring to, saying that we can plunge. At least that would be my take on it. Good question though, Ryan.
I think I short some names, but they're flushing here. I'm not seeing much bounce. Woo! The problem when we get these moves, we don't get too much bounce there. We get it really early and trying to find something and seeing everything just leak, 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 leak. And I hate shorting into the kind of red candles. I like to short into green candles.
Amazon now down about a whole $1.30. If you haven't already gotten, I'm all out of Amazon, but if you're not 100%, I would start scaling out, because you've got BWAP around 109 and would not be surprised if we see a little bit of a bounce there.
So I'm seeing more of these penny plays go. CSCW seems to be the newest one. ALNA was the big one from earlier. That's pulled back here now to the 65 EMA, nonetheless. But a lot of these penny plays going. XCur tried to go. ABEO tried to go. Tour trading up a little bit. So some of these pennies, ALNA, yeah, we talked about that. So anyway.
All right. If you went ahead and short AMD on the break of VWAP, you've got a decision to make here. You've got AMD testing the lows of the days around 77 bucks. If it cracks below, would not be surprised to see 76, 75, even if the market continues to the downside. But you want to go ahead and scale out if you're a short VWAP, because we could easily come back and try to test it once again on AMD. As you could get a double bottom here. I don't see it happening, but my money is not where my mouth is. I'm not trading it. Just calling it out for y'all.
All right, short PG here, Procter & Gamble.
HCGM was fun. I agree with you.
Short value here, essentially. I'm going on Procter & Gamble. I've been seeing the value trade come off. So short here, Procter & Gamble. This is going to be more of a swing trade position. I do like the daily. If it get below 140 on the daily, we could see some leakage come into 135s and down there towards the low. So that's going to be my level here. What's my out? Anything above 142.50 is going to be my out on Procter & Gamble. So taking the short there, going to look for it to kind of crack on down here, getting short off of the kind of the VWAP area, looking for it to hold, make sure that it doesn't just bounce up there, and then cutting down towards 140 is what we're looking for. Swing trade on. No more day trades on the day, just swing trades for me.
GHSI, another stock that's running now, another penny stock. NBRV.
Lucid.
Art saying I'm trading the Rev Strat day down. Awesome. We've got some more Strat traders in here. I don't, just for the record, I don't trade a Strat strategy. What I will, what I do though, is I pretty much look at candles as one, two, and three now. So I'm able to identify some of those. And by the way, one of the things I really like are reversals, especially on stocks that are showing momentum. When they get yanked, when it looks like they're trying to reverse, that's when I really like that. So I'm predominantly using a 1 minute chart looking for reversals.
I think Beach Bum, was it? Yeah, he was asking if I was out of Gush. I never got into Gush. I did play Chevron for a little bit of some upside. I'm still in XOM though. Still in ExxonMobil. We did add today at 91.50, so not looking too bad right now. The low on the day is like 40s. I could also add towards 91, but that's literally where my entry is. So I'm looking at 91.08 as my cost average. Drip is the opposite of Gush. Yeah, those are some quick traders. Definitely could make some good money on those. Those are highly leveraged. They're 2x. I think they used to even be 3x, but they took one of the x off. What was the old one that I used to trade? Was it DWT? Yeah, it used to be that one. DWT. There used to be some other one that was around, but kind of disappeared when oil had that trouble. All right, energy definitely pulling back today. Basic materials, technology pulling back, industrials. What is on the upside? Absolutely nothing from the open is on the upside. So that just shows me that if I'm trading long right now, might be doing it wrong.
Amen to that.
Right, CJ? Might be doing it wrong.
You've got HCGM testing BWAP here. Needs to get over 115. If you want to go short, sell at spot, get out 117.
Jay Wild saying that NRSN is curling totally. Coming right back through three here. Starting to get some volume here too. Saw some size at what looked like 304. This is an interesting one here. Kind of want to take a stab at this. Jay, are you in this one? We had this one pegged from earlier.
Okay, MX.
I might try this. Let's see if I can get this below.
I bet
you
did.
They're not filling me.
Like that one.
There we go. There we go. So filled some here at 299. Going to be a tight stop. Definitely not going to let this go red on me, but I think that maybe we take a move back up here towards what, 320, 324? We'll see. Yeah. Jay, you're in from 280. Wow. You got an awesome entry. Well, thank you for the shout. I'm back in it now. Here we go. Let's see if we can push. 305 is where they stopped it the first time. Let's see if we take that out. There's 304, some size there. They're taking it. Gone. More size at 305. Let's see if they take that. There's 305 again. They're taking it. And they're not yet. They're hitting it, though, but they're not clearing it out yet. You guys, can you take a look? While I'm in this trade, can one of you manage to take a look at Apple?
Sure. Got you.
We're getting your request from the chat. Mitch, I'm throwing up your screen.
Of course. I just wanted to tell you guys, I just went swing short here on CarMax. I talked about this in pre-market prep. I thought this was a really good short opportunity. I did miss the VWAP fade there, but I'm taking a swing short here. So we'll look to see if this doesn't get back above those resistance here. So that's around 93.72s. We're going to, it's a kind of smaller trade, but we're looking for a bigger size move here. We're looking for a move back down there towards 88 on the daily. From there, we can look for a washout to 85. This is all based on also the mentality of a Carvana just getting killed lately. And so I'm looking at CarMax short there. Let's go to Apple here. Let's take a look there. You did see a bounce where we filled the gap yesterday. Now you're seeing a bounce again. Probably seeing this overall market bouncing also. There you guys see it coming right back to the highs. Some choppiness in the overall market and the queues. But Apple, yeah, coming back there. What's the levels to kind of keep on watch? You can look at the 15-minute or an hourly. You're going to get back into some resistance around the 140-50 area. If it does get up there, that's probably the next level of resistance. But it is finding some bounce after kind of closing in this gap that it had on the 24th, and now you're seeing it kind of close into there. Right now you'll run into some of that. That's going to be at 139.80. So look how it closes up above this 139.80 if you get that move into the 140s.
I am going to go short AMD here. I'll tell you exactly what my fails are. Give me one moment. Shoot. Went ahead and popped above you. I'm getting it. I'm going to go ahead and short here at 78.09.
B-hat at it again. Yeah, it doesn't look too bad there. I talked about potentially pullbacks as 275, 278. Went down there towards 264s. Doesn't look too bad. Now pulling back there after it clicked above the VWAP there. So we'll see if it gets back into the $3 handle. All right. What else is going on out there?
Excuse me. Took NRSN off here. Seems heavy. I'm actually going to wait now, not expose myself to a pullback. Wait for the 305 break on NRSN. Looked like B-Hat was curling too, although that's yanked here as well.
Hendrix is up. That means the market is probably up.
What's going on, Hendrix? Give him the pets for the group here.
Yes, yes, yes. Hendrix.
Good Hendrix. You should see, buddy. He is literally just staring at the door. He hears all this work outside.
Oh, I'm sure. Does he go into hide mode?
No, he does not go into hide mode. He goes into, I want to help you. I want to smell your tools. I want to get under all the stuff that you're doing. I want to run out the front door. He does not go into hide mode. He makes it very difficult for me and for the workmen that are here. So he needs to stay in his own room. Maybe take him for bathroom breaks. It's an embarrassing situation for sure.
I can't blame him. My cat actually goes into hide mode. So I used to love that when I used to sneak him, because I first got him when I was in a dorm in college and there wasn't allowed pets. So like if anybody came in, he went into hide mode. So Well, I see that yours wasn't one, the one to have in college.
Nope. This cat acts like a dog. Okay, so that's how I would describe it. Buddy has more dog personality in him than cat personality. He loves to be around people. He plays fetch. I don't know if you've ever had a cat that plays fetch. Mine does. It's pretty awesome, actually. Dope. And yeah, he loves people. He's like a dog in that way.
Hey, I love that.
Bye, Roland. Have a good one.
All right. Looking to see if I can get an ad here on that. Boom. Just got an ad, a small ad there on the CarMax short.
AMD. Got to go ahead and take some here at the 78s.
All right. So now I'm swing short on PG and CarMax and swing long on ExxonMobil, still holding on to that. It's not looking too bad there. Keeps holding around the 91.50 level. If we can get a close back above 93, that's going to look really well on the day. So I don't mind the pullback here. Adding on the pullbacks, looking for it to continue its trend.
Let's see what the SPY is doing. So far, SPY has a higher high. Wanted to come down below VWAP, that would be great.
Yeah, I haven't taught Hendrix to fetch. He's a big laser killer, though.
Oh, he chases the laser pointer?
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah. If he sees a laser, dude, that guy goes insane.
Yep, same.
Daniel, he'll jump like 6 feet.
That's props on that. Buddy would not take orders.
Nah, the only order is go to the garage. Hendrix likes to follow me to the garage. All right, looking good there on CarMax. It rejected the VWAP, which is what I wanted to see there. So we'll look for it to kind of continue here. The overall market, what's up with the overall market here? Seeing a little bit of a bounce, definitely choppiness. Wouldn't you expect it? We haven't gotten out of the hourly range here. And we've talked about this often, how some of the times we got to be careful as day traders when we're just seeing hourly chop. And a lot of that is right now, any close above 382 would be a good level on the hourly. Anything closing below 379 would be a short side on the SPY. And until we break that range, it's probably going to be a little bit choppy here. Show you guys that right here. So you guys can see here, pre-market levels. You can see here the hourly. Every time we go up there, we wick. Every time we go down here, we wick. We want to see it actually close up there or close down here to at least give us direction.
Super chop.
Gonna have to get a food processor for the SPY.
I'll probably misspoke on AMD here. Let me go back to my chart and then I'll head out. On AMD, what I did is I went short at the 78s. And then when it kind of came back down below, here it is. This is where my price action was. And then when it went ahead and tried to test it again right here, this VWAP is where I added it at 78s. And then I took some at 77.70s. And I'm going to take some actually here in the 50s. Oh, hell yes. Sorry, give me one moment. Take off another leg here. Took off another leg at 77.55. And I'm not going to lie. The rest, I'm gonna be a little bit of a greedy SOB. I'm going to go shower. I'm just going to set my stop loss at 78.34 is my stop loss. I've got about maybe 10-15% shares remaining. And then I'm going to be greedy. I'm not even going to take it out at around 77.20s. I'm going to wait to see if this thing wants to crack to the 76s or so. But made a solid trade on it, made a good amount of money on it. And just now my stop loss is set and I'm going to enjoy this trade. Hopefully it doesn't stop me out. And if it does, I'm okay. So that's the review on it. Basically tested VWAP and didn't quite crack it. Went right back below. So for me, you can see this candle on Hopefully you guys can see my mouse. But this candle here at 1025 tested VWAP. When it couldn't break through and I saw this one here around 1028, I went in and added some more. And my stop loss was right above. So like 7832s, I believe, was my stop loss, which lo and behold might be something that gets taken out right now. And this is exactly why you want to scale out. You're not trying to hit a home run. You're trying to make sure you get solid, solid profits out the way. Mm-hmm. But that'll do it for me, y'all. I'm going to try to hop on tomorrow, but with this hotel and working till midnight, 1 o'clock, it gets a little draining. But I'll Slack you guys here in a sec. Are we trading on Friday? Do we know?
I am not. I am off
all access. All access.
Okay, cool. So
which I'm should gonna, be fun.
Cool. Sounds good. I've just been trading stock. Usually I trade options, but I'm going to wait till I get back home to trade all that. So right now I'm just trading equities. But yeah, good luck, you guys. See ya.
Take care, Zunaid.
Appreciate you. All right, time to keep it going here. Let's take a look at the overall market. And wouldn't you know it, it went up there for a slight second towards the top side of this range, but rejects to close above it here. So I'm just going to leave this 5 minute here to kind of keep on watch. Let's go towards like six charts and start putting that on here. So I got the Qs in the middle here. I'll put the SPY here. And you can see here rejections to get above 382s. Nvidia bottoming a little bit there. Let's put maybe Apple here on the bottom side. Bottom right, I'm going to put Tesla. And on the top right, let's go ahead. Let's put XOM, my swing. Keeping an eye on that. Let's see how that kind of performs. We got an add on this candle here. We're testing down there towards those lows. We'll see if it gets to 91 today. I'm not going to let it crack through there.
Tusher, I don't have a Zing token update for you. You'd have to ask the head of that project. You can email mobile@benzinga.com and get your update that way. Please don't spam. We don't want to time you out.
Zing token. Zing, zing. All right. What are you guys seeing on out there? Do you guys see anything you guys want to check on out? Throw it up in the chat. I'll go ahead and take a look. Looks like we're at 10:35 there today. I don't know if we'll make it to 11:30 today. Things are a little bit slow, at least in my eyes.
Yeah, they are.
I can keep taking a look. I can keep taking a look. It feels a little slower, the action out there.
So we might actually be dealing with kind of a slower market here until we get the CPI and PPI numbers. I believe that's July 15 and 16. Let me see here real quick. Let me try to figure this out here. But yeah, CPI print, PPI print, that's what we're going to be looking at. That's July. Let's go through here. Oops. Okay.
Mo Herbert, he got me to laugh at least. Appreciate you, Mo. Core PCE tomorrow. NIO says NA. Man, if only I got short NIO yesterday. You guys heard me talk about it in the pre-market. I was looking at that one on a daily short. Like, it looked really nice there for the 22.67 break. And yesterday was a great day if you would have got that with the short report coming on out. But July, I would look for it to get back above those levels. Kind of maybe fill the gap. Get towards those like 22.50. Maybe you can use that 2260 as resistance. For right now, I'm still not into it, but I think it can have one more lift.
So, excuse me, the July, the CPI print in July is July 13th.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that's interesting. The 13th.
Yep. Okay. And I believe the, and I think the PPI print is the 15th. Let me check the calendar here. 13 and 15. It's the Wednesday and Friday. That's what it is.
Ouchie, wouchie. Market heading down, Chris, here right now.
Right on the head here real quick. CPI, then JPM earnings. I believe, Chris, is the JPM earnings, when is that the 15th? Let me see. That I should be able to figure out pretty easily. They've already confirmed that, haven't they?
Out on the swing trade on XOM. Lost their 3 cents on it, looking for it to come down. I don't mind getting back in XOM like I did yesterday. We did take good gains in 93s. But not going to let it fight my break even. My rules are on swing trade. Once you make one profit, don't fight that break-even spot, because that's how you let a winner become a loser. So we took that winner. It's still a win. Give yourself a pat on the back, follow your rules, and continue moving forward. But we are swing short on some stocks today, like PG.
Cut all pennies KMX. On my scanner.
So now those looking good here. So we can actually use the profits that we got on XOM to maybe increase sizing on one of these trades, either PG, XO, KMX, or we could look for another trade. I'm actually probably look for XOM to come back closer towards 90 and then maybe look for a dip buy in that one. But for right now, I want to see it kind of balance out here. Ethereum. That's what I should be trading? Probably. Who knows? All right, so save myself a couple cents there on the XOM. It would have got me into the red here. And so that's why I always try to just be smart with those swing trades. A lot of times for me, I'm not going to let it go red after green. It just doesn't make sense for me after you took some profit to let it go back into the red and give some of that profit back.
Nice little pull here in oil. Let's see what that leads to.
And you can see here, Apple coming back to the highs, trying to reject there again there from the highs. We'll see if it gets on through the 140s. SPY probably coming back up there too. The chop continues, man. It's a chop fest.
I think it's going to, like I said, we need some new catalysts to really kind of break out of that chop fest. And I don't think you're going to get that until the middle of July. We're in summer trading, folks. If you got vacations to take, if you like golf, go do it. Don't necessarily waste your time watching every tick. There's definitely going to be opportunity, but as you see here today, it's the junk that's running. It's not good stuff.
Yep. That's how it is sometimes. Haven't seen a faster chop fest in a long time, says Jay Rice. This is when you want to just be kind of sized down. Hit the break. That's what I'm doing, guys. Like even the day trades that I took today, at least I didn't lose too much because they're very limited on the sizing. Even my swing trades have been limited on the sizing. So that XOM one was doing really, really well, though. I mean, we got that first profit at 93, and that was from 91 below that, at 91.03. And then when we added, we got there towards 91.08. But there you guys have it. It's a struggle in this market to make a gain. And a lot of that is with the chop of the overall market and the queues. When you get in that chopping action, it's just hard to keep trends. Look how Apple now just trying to push through the highs here. SPY trying to push through the highs. Can't get through it just yet. We'll see what happens.
Hang on a second. Hang on.
I agree with Seth. Unless full-time trading, you should probably be studying charts and levels. This is summer volume in a bear market. Understand that completely. One of the things is we're here to trade, so I don't think anybody would want to see a show where we didn't take a single trade. We're going to keep trying, but I understand, Seth, and kind of agree with you. Could see some rippage come here? Yeah, Jonathan, you could. Just want to see the SPY finally pick a level. It hasn't. Neither has the Qs. Look here on the hourly. Hourly levels are still being respected. If we can get out of the range, then we can really see that lift. Definitely one of those days that I'm going to need some energy drink to get through the day. Feeling a little tired today. Agree. Zest. We'll always kind of state it on both sides there. say what you got to say. I think it's important too to get it out there to traders. There's nothing wrong with what you said, Seth. Of course, we won't lose confidence. It's just a part of the game. Looks like a double top drop. Says Thotty by Nature. I like that name right there, Thotty by Nature. Pretty dope screen name there. Thotty by Nature. Looking at XOM, trying to see some actual like bottoming action there. So we're gonna use, for that, we'll use three, well, we can use the five. Let's use the five. We wanna see 2 5-minute create us a level. The third one, try to tick on up and then come back. When it comes back, we want to see that hold and we can try to catch it on XOM.
All right, Mitch, I'm sorry to leave you, but I got to get rolling.
Get rolling, my friend. No worries. I know there's plenty of more in life to do than just this. So go ahead and knock it out and get that AC fix, my brother. I know you're going to be sleeping good tonight. Hopefully. Put that AC down, baby. We're gonna have to send you a little extra
energy. I'm literally as soon as it's fixed, I'm setting it to 69. Nice.
Polar bear. I'm just gonna leave it there. Polar bear that thing tonight, Lord Ryan. I wish you the best, man. Have a great day.
Thanks. Take care.
All right. Much love there. There you go. Everybody giving him some love. Get that AC fixed, Ryan. All right. Music's coming up a little bit. As you guys can hear, it's probably a little loud, but that's just because, you know. It's kind of, you know, hanging out there, but AC on 65, let's do it. Now we're seeing XOM really down there to 90 60s. This is why I wanted to be careful about hanging on to the trade, right? So a lot of times when you're doing swing trades in this environment, it's okay to stay in the trade, but if the trend breaks, you don't want to be a part of the trend. So I'm kind of glad I got out of there. Now we're going towards deeper and deeper lows, which is at the 90 50s. We're going to let it try to break through there, try to get into closing some of this shadow. So that's down there even towards 89, 67. Let's see if we can get somewhere near 90 and we can take a shot for it to come back to 93. SPY trying to get above that level. We talked about this at 382s. Can it get up there and start pushing? NVIDIA down. We're gonna see if these are coming back here. Let's go to ARKK. That'd show us a little bit of a signal if we're getting kind of that push back. TWO having a good day today. Man, that thing's up 23%. Could come back and fill the gap though later on the day. Twillo finding some bottoming action, looking like good on the chart. Just pushed up on a 5-minute. Could see that continuing. Roadblocks, I fought it earlier. Unity having a good day. He's probably having a good day also. There you go. Holding on. You guys saw me stop out of this earlier. We'll see what happens on this one. Trying to see if the SPY traps again there. Yep. There's a little bit of a trap. Went up through the 382 and rejected it again. SPY needs to break through the PM high of 382.25. I like that level, Julie. I like it. Double top on the 30. You got it. Exactly. Literally. Looks like almost a triple top there. This is why sometimes we're going to see things break the range, right? XOM coming down there now towards 90.24s. Are we going to get there towards the 90 mark so that I can start taking a little bit of a shot there? And maybe we can add there towards it. I'm willing to take another shot in XOM. Get back in it. Maybe a dollar lower. Not too bad to take a shot there. We'll see if it gets through the 90. All right, let's see my other trades, how those are going right now. Let's see CMX or KMX, CarMax, fighting here to try to get back above 93.50s. We don't want to see it get back above 93.72s. We are going to try to go swing short on this, so we want to eventually see this trend line break. and then head down into this area, take out the lows, and then continue through 92, going towards that 91. We'll see what happens. PG is another one. You know, we got swing short. We're looking for a move back down towards that 140. We want to see this kind of break a trend line here. You can see here how we've been kind of getting on up there. You want to see it kind of reject that 142 move and come on down there. XOM now down there towards 90.12. Did anybody see some oil trades out there? Mitch, I know you're on all day, but bring that back. What happened to Let's Get Technical? Neil didn't want to. Neil has some other stuff he's doing. He's doing education for Benzinga now. So he's on the B2C team. He's a lot of what's behind the trading school. So he doesn't do Get Technical anymore. There's the break. Looking for that continued break here. All right. Trying to get back below 90s here. There's the cut. Looking at XOM right here, guys, might take a little bit of a starter position and look to add it into a third. So a little bit slowly at first, then look to add to it. Let's see where it's at also on something like a, we could take a look at maybe like a Bollinger Band, but I'm also taking a look here at the RSIs. So let's go towards the hourly. Take a look at the RSI on the hourly. So it could come lower a little bit here, at least from what the RSI is. Look for a test up here. Closer towards that number here. So we got a little bit more to go down there towards that. Look for a move back towards like, let's say 36 here. So I bounced there off the 90s there. Could have got 90s. It went to 89.91 there. Maybe getting a little bit picky here now. SPY trying to get through that high. It's trying. We'll see what happens there. Let's go towards the three charts. LI still pushing up towards the top there. NIO still had a little bit of room to run there. Still looking good there. Let's go towards XOM here on the left-hand side. That cut down through 89, 90s there. Let's look if we get that one more push down into that area. Q's still fighting, trying to get back above that 285, 25 level, I would say. That's the level kind of to watch now. Keeps rejecting though, off of those highs. SPY still not out of the range here. Oxy is crowded. Yeah, it is. Looking for another leg down here in XOM. Not getting it right now. I did get a little bounce there to 90.40s. The SPY is just trappy out there. It's tough. MRO is still my favorite long, but chart is uglier now. Yeah, let's take a look at MRO. All right, MRO finding a little bounce around that 2340 mark. I don't know why I had that written, but let's take a look here. Looks like it's also trying to fill in the gap there. So maybe a move towards 23. Don't trust SPY here. It says Quantum. Can't blame you. Been seeing a lot of fake outs. Another rejection from breaking out above that 285.25 on the Qs. Let's see a rejection here on PG. Come right back down there. Mullen. Yeah, nothing moving yet, but I did see that kind of big orders going there, big volume. All right, let's take a look at the sectors. What's going on out there? Let's go. All right, SPY rejecting again one time there. So now we are seeing healthcare come on up here. So that's interesting. Some of these cheaper names are making moves, guys. So I like AEZS. Look at this little cheap name here. Trying to get back up to 32 cents from 27. Definitely a cheaper name there. AGEN. I think we've talked about that one today. NRSN looks interesting here. Actually like this one here. Let's maybe play something on the upside here on a cheaper name, like NRSN. Taking a look here at that one. See if the volume can come back into it. Doesn't look too bad here. 15 minute. Kind of sideways pending here off the 280s. Move back above 3, going to 325 is what I'm looking at. Don't know this one too much, but hey, doesn't look too bad. Not a bad setup there. XLV, only green sector you got. Yeah, healthcare. Healthcare is green. But let's look at some of the high cap names there. See what's moving. J&J up a little bit here. UNH, PFE. I did see mentions by the FDA that we might need to have some kind of new vaccine. So that's why you're maybe seeing Moderna take a nice spike there, up about 1.6%. Probably Pfizer also. This one looks like an interesting one here. Just off the VWAP now, so I might take a shot here. Let me see if I can get it here, guys. There you go. Just got in there. 51.12s. Let's hold off the 51s. Let's look for a move back above 51.30s here. So taking a long here on Pfizer. A lot of mentions of the FDA and that we're going to need vaccines again here. So let's see if this one can get back on up there. A little VWAP bounce action. See if we can get it through. Resistance support down at 51.04s. Let's see if it just starts pushing back here. Trying to take some more trades so that we don't get too lost in the sauce here. All right, I did see mentioned of SOXX, SOXS, kind of the semiconductor one. That looks interesting there. Nice little VWAP play there, nice little wave action. Looking good here off of the 63 kind of 11s. Let's see if this gets up through 64. BAC, says Daniel. Looks like it's coming down there. Looks like it doesn't want to hold the gains right now. SPY, what'd it do? It rejects, wouldn't you know it? It's just a trap out there in the market overall. Gotta be careful. XRM now down there to 90.17. All right, one of my trades is going into the green here, which is CarMax here, guys. So that's looking good there on CarMax. The swing short there on CarMax is looking interesting. I'm going to stay in this one, look for it to continue down. Doesn't look too bad now. CarMax getting into the green. Let's take a look at PG. I'm going to look to see if that one can't just keep going on up. That is consumer defensives. Don't want to see that continue into the green. but it could push up today. There are some names that are green. Smash the like, guys. Let's go. ABT. ABT is Abbott Labs. It is holding well there. We'll see if that can continue going through 108s. Daily chart has some support underneath it. MDT. Yep, MDT, medical device. I don't know this one too much, so I'm not going to do too much comments on that one, but it doesn't look too bad either. All right, guys, let's see where we're at on the like game here. Let's see if we can get the likes that we need to continue going through 11. Like always, guys, we go ahead and give a goal to see if we can continue going from 11 to 1130. But let's take a look here and see where we're at on the like department. Looks like we got 227. Let's go. Let's do 250. I won't ask for too much here. So we need 20 more likes here to keep us going. LI. All right, let's take a look there. Interesting pattern there. Doesn't look bad at all. Still holding there. NIO, did we get up there towards that high? No, we got towards a high of 228. Wanted to see if it could close the gap into that space here. If we take a look at the hourly, you'll see that gap came right into a low of 22.30s. So gap fill and then play the reversal there. That's what I think that one looks interesting there. Doesn't look too bad now. Seen a couple of drives on up. I'm willing to go swing short on this one. Let's see if I can get just even a little bit of shares here. Let it push one more time here and then look to see maybe if I can get the swing short on. All right, there you go, guys. Boom, boom. You guys wanted to keep me on. Can't blame you guys. Let's just keep going. ML. Money Lion. All right, let's take a look there. Money Lion looks like a bearish chart that wants to head towards the lows. Had a lot of support around 139, but you're seeing that get pressured right now. Next level is 120 on the downside. All right, let's go back to Pfizer, guys, where we took the long there. Let's see how this is working out. Do we get this push here or not? Been in it for a little bit over the 3 minute mark now. So let's see the push there above the 51.15s going to 51.25. And then you want to see the volume expand. One thing that's helping is look how the RSI is starting to give us a little bit of a trickle up. So on the RSI, what we're going to look to see for confirmation is for it to continue into this zone here. So you want it to come back up through this 62 on the RSI. That's going to show us confirmation that our position's looking good. This is how I use indexes, guys, or indicators. A lot of the time, what I want to see more long is confirmation once I'm in that it's going in the right direction. So we got in when the RSI was actually down here at 35.71 here on the 3 minute. Now you're looking for it to continue in this direction, showing you that breakout. Been using this more like comparison here towards the overall healthcare and drug manufacturers. So you can see here the difference in color is important because what happens is, and so let me make this kind of a little bit bigger here. I'll bring the volume down here so it doesn't take up a whole bunch of space here. And so one of the things that you're looking at is how is the sector and industry moving here? So you can see here, this is in drug manufacturers and it's actually been moving down here while healthcare was moving up. Now it's coming more in line, and we're going to look to see if this can come on back up. So this is a good thing to draw also here is the sector and industry. If you see a trend, look for it to try to hold there and keep holding that trend. All right, let's see if we get that. A tick below this trend line is what we don't want to see. Gotta have the patience, Julie. In this type of market, if you don't have patience, you give up gains. So a lot of the times when you see moments like this, it's okay just to say, you know what, I'm gonna watch Money Mitch maybe make or lose some money right now, and I'm gonna keep my hands underneath and just sit on them and just, I ain't taking a trade today. It happens sometimes, guys. It's okay to tell yourself that. If you're not seeing it, tell yourself, let's keep the money in our pockets and not just give it back. Seeing that NIO reject there to come back up towards that 2230s. Looks interesting, but I'm leaving that alone right now. DD rejecting, that's a good sign for me on my swing. KMX, CarMax coming down there. Not bad there, guys. That's looking good there for us. XOM, now down there towards 89.66. So we can keep our eyes on Pfizer. Maybe we're going to take a shot on XOM on this pullback, but we'll see right now. What happens in Pfizer here? I would keep an eye also on Moderna. I see Moderna's kind of continue to push. You can see we had that push. Now it pulled back. Let's look for Moderna to take out the highs. And then also you'll see kind of this is what we call the leader lagger trade. So I'm going to put it on here so you guys can follow that. So that's PFE, Moderna. Watch this, guys. That's what we're going to take a look here. I'll put the three so it's a little bit faster action here. Let's see if this can get back on up. Getting up here. And then, of course, Moderna, you want to see it come back towards the highs here. HTGM gearing up for the move, Hex. I'll take a look. HTGM. I don't know why I was being dyslexic there. Yeah, similar, kind of hanging out sideways there like Pfizer is on the VWAP, right? Doesn't look too bad there if you look at the 15. I do like that 15 hold here. It came back here, held that pullback to 101. Now trying to get back up there towards the 130s here. It doesn't look too bad there. Could make another push on up. Like always, just know your out game. And I don't think it's a bad little play here. Another thing you can see here is higher and higher lows. So make sure that trend continues also. Higher and higher lows. You can see here on the 15 minute. Want to see it start closing above this. See what happens there. XOM, I'm getting pounded. I'm glad I got out, right? I took some profit on that today. I don't think there's too many people probably nailed profits on XOM today, at least on the long side. Really close to getting out here on Pfizer. You can see here it tested the 5104s there. All right, what's working well for us is now PG is rejecting a little bit there. How's our SPY? SPY rejecting, coming towards the low now. Can we break down through the 379? That's where we get some downside continuation. There you go, CarMax, keep it going. PG is the one that's not doing too well. Might have to cut this one and add towards CarMax. Gonna give it a couple more seconds here. If not, gonna probably cut PG. I'm not down big in this, but I also don't want to get to that point either. There's no need to if you're not seeing it working your way. There you guys see it. Another little push there. If it gets above this 142.25, I'll go ahead and I'll just get out.
rejecting that level. So I'll just go ahead and I can set a stop there. Stop placed at 142.27. So if it gets back above that, it'll just stop me out. Buys are catching a little bit of a bounce there off the 5104s. Good level. Now we need to see it get back to the 5120s. Let's go to that HTGM. There it is. Good luck, my friend. Good luck. Look at that. Nice look there, man. Shout out to you, Hex. Shout out to you, Hex. I got you, dude. Good luck. And it got the volume that you wanted to see. So look at the crossover on the MACD. Boom, nice little crossover. Now you want to see this line extend, right? And so you want to get it further away. Further away, further away. So this line, you don't want to see it coming in. You want to see it expanding out. Looking good there on HTGM. Darina. Trying to push back to the highs. That was going to look good for us on Pfizer. Flex, flex. Smooth beats with Money Mitch on Benzinga. Boom. Let's go, guys. There you go, that's looking good there. XOM starting to find some bottoming action there. Looking interesting on for me to catch that one on a huge dip after probably swung a lot of people out of the trade there. How's our SPY? SPY just hanging out still, man. We're still not out of the range. That's when you get caught a lot of the times, guys. So one of the things that I would say is take learning lessons from what we've been talking about, maybe on just trying to see the SPY get out of its range. And then when it gets out of its range, does it continue in a trend? We're looking for trending days. Yesterday, we got that when we finally got that breakdown through, right? It flushed and it flushed, flush, 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 flush. That's what we need to kind of pay attention to as traders right now. At least that's what I'm seeing. Still some choppy action. Just got out of that PG. Out of the PG now. Pfizer's still holding there, so I'm still into that one. I'm willing to take the XOM swing back. Let's go with that. Starter on there. Starter on at 89.77 on XOM. So we got out at 91 for the break even, right? That was right here. Now we're getting back into the trade. Just a full what? Let's take a look here. What is that? That'd be about 1.35% lower. So saving me that 1.5, 1.3. Just got my starter. Willing to add this in thirds. So just going to take it easy. If I do get another break of 89.50 going to 89, then I can add there. Remember, we're also looking for this to maybe potentially get the fill in to the gap zone. Let's look at that gap zone here. It's actually down here towards here. Towards 89.11. Let's see the high there. We're going to put the high at 89.08. Thank you. Now let's go back to it. It's kind of the line in the sand there for the gap fill and then the pop back. So we're going to look for it to come back to that level, around that level, 89.25s, 89.10s. That's where I'll look to get my second ad. And I'll tick below that will be the third. Where do you get your music? I get it from YouTube here. It's a lo-fi. It's a common stream. It's, you know, it's kind of copy-free music. You guys can check it out. Got you. I'll put up the link here. We use them so often. Got to give them a shout out. Pfizer about to stop me out there, guys. It gets to 51. See if it gets on up. XOM, man, they're weak. Weak in oil. All right, taking a look around here. What else is making moves? SPY heading back down towards the lows. Let's see what happens. Some more trappy candles there. Can we take a look at Veru on the daily? I'm on the fence. What to do next? Well, like always, Jessica, I can't tell you exactly what to do, but I can tell you what I see on the chart of Veru. All right, let's go. All right, Veru coming on down there towards 11. So let's take a look at the daily. Daily has a lot of action where it just rejected the 13. And so I was looking for another attempted push. I always talk about the rule of four. There's one, two, three. Was looking for that last push. It looks like we got it here and it just failed to even get back towards the resistance, which was this push on this day where you got to push towards 1448, could not hold to get back above that. And now I'd be a little bit careful as you're seeing that pullback. Could go to 10 here, at least from what I see on the chart. And you got to make your decision. Hey, did I just kind of watch this trade and it just didn't go my way and I'm sticking around? You got to always ask yourself that question. That's the only thing I can say there. Got you, Julie. Got you, Robert. Enjoy it, guys. I jammed to that station more than you guys probably even imagine. Give me 1 second, guys. I'm just going to drink some water. Got to get your water right. Water check. Water check. All right, guys. As you guys can see, today is definitely some slower action. We're seeing a lot of slowness on out there. So we'll see what happens now. SPY coming on down there towards 380, but not much going on. I'm going to go ahead and play a quick trailer, and I'll be back like always, guys. Just smash the like, guys, and let's keep it going here.
Breaking news. U.S. Treasuries. In the case of nuclear or radiological fallout, people living around the
RTW retail wins hitting a high of 45 cents. Seeing some chat room mention on RTW retail wins. Coming up at 2 p.m. Eastern Time today, the federal budget balance for January. Earnings after the close today from EFX, Equifax, MGM, MGM Resorts, NTAP NetApp, and U.S. New Skin, PS Pluralsight, TRIP, TripAdvisor reporting after the close.
Had to take a quick little break there. What's up, guys? I'm about to mow the backyard. Dang, I'll do that with you, Daniel. Got the backyard right here. This is one of those days, guys. A little slow action there. Stopped out of PFE too, man. A little 10 cent stop out, but it's just not going on. Nothing wants to hold the pattern there. So stopped out right here. That happens, guys. It's just not one of those days where we're seeing a lot of continuation, slowing up action. Hendrix did some trades. I knew he was up to something. Music on point. Hodo. Do one for me too, man. Don't roll one. Roll two. SRT 8 Challenger. Talk to me nice, Mitch. Nike's going up to 110. Take a look there. Let's go take a look. Nike. Look at the daily chart here. See what we're seeing compared to the accessories. Looks like it's holding up better there, consumer cyclicals, than the footwear accessories. Let's take a look here on the longer term RSI. Where are the extreme points for Nike? I always look at extreme points, right? And so what I do is I just look at the chart. Looks like extreme for Nike is actually down there towards 12. So I think this could come back down and kind of crack this on the RSI here, then head down a little bit further. But doesn't mean you're too much further down there, but you could get a crackdown on the RSI. Right now, you are seeing a little bit of a bounce back here. Take a look at the 15. Let's go to the hourly, kind of clean this up a little bit. It needs to get back up towards this support here, which is that 104.90s. You can see how it's fighting the 105s right now. If you see a close above 105s, I'd be like a little bit more bullish, but it needs to close above 105 today. If not, it's continued on the downside there. XOM, finally getting towards that level that we talked about here. So we're going to take our second entry if we can get to 89.10s here. Order out there at 89.10s. See if I get the fill there, and then we're going to keep building the swing position. So our first entry was 89.77. It's right around here. Now we're looking to get another add here towards the gap fill. We went towards 89.12s. I'm at 89.10s. Pen short, says someone out there. All right, I can take a look there. Trying to get someone pregnant with this music, says Daniel. Hey, trying to maybe get the market. Let's get this to 300 likes. Let's go, Grizzly Bull. HTGM, 131s. Looks like you got towards the high of the day. At least for me, I would have been taking profits towards that 128. So not a bad move there with my man, Hex Pony. Good shout out there, my friend. Pen. Let's do this. Pen, 3102s. Nah. You know what, guys? It's time to change up this music, guys. I'm gonna go to something that I normally don't play here, but why not? Can't hold back here. No holding back. Let's go. See what I want to play here. All right. Let's see what I'm gonna play here. All right. No, I'm definitely going to get hit up for this song, but why not? Let's go for it. You guys have it. Oh, no, we don't need the commercial. I get that premium. There you go. Got a little bit of an ad on XOM, and we cracked through 89s here and go to 88, about 75. I'll go ahead and I'll get that last ad there for us on the swing trade for XOM. Hey, a little bit of some logic for us. Hey. Got to turn it up a little bit today. Hey. I'll get to the reggae quantum. I got you. I just wanted to turn up the energy a little bit. And no matter what they say, it's my day. This is logic every day.
feeling real good. Think you gon' talk shit, you better not. My homies real hood. They say logic, why you do that? I don't know, I don't know. Yeah, they used to be like who that? I don't know, I don't know.
Did we finally get on through there? Oh, now it's heading towards the downside on the spy. Just be careful out there, guys. Just as quick as you could fall. Let's go. Watching Tesla's time in sales. What lot size represents retail traders? Trying to look for ways to identify concentration of retail traders. I love that comment, Gene. Let's do that. Logic is corny? Hey, you could think logic is corny. It's up to you. All right. Let's go ahead. Let's keep it going. Let's take a look here at that Tesla comment. I like that comment. That's why I'm going to go ahead and check that out. That's what I look for a lot of the times. So for Tesla, let's go ahead. Let's look at time and sales here. Just give me a second here so I can show you what I would do here. So a lot of times when we're looking at time and sales, right, there's a lot of action that's going to show up, right? We're looking at Tesla here. We're looking at their time and sales. A lot of times you're going to see that action just coming on in. So what I like to do here is decipher, right? What is algorithmic volume? What is retail traders? The algorithmic volume is that hundreds that you see going through there. Sometimes even the ones, like one, but where the retail trading is, where you see that kind of change in there, like 462, you see 38. When you're seeing those hundreds, I consider that more algorithmic volume. So what I would do on Tesla is I would filter to, like, let's say 500 or 1,000. It's up to you. I'll filter here towards 1,000 and you'll see what? All of a sudden the volume slows down because you're not seeing that big order go through there. And so a lot of times I'll have multiple time in sales to go ahead and do what? I'm trying to catch those big orders that you talked about, those big retail traders. And so what you're trying to also see is where the institutionals are lining up too. So sometimes you see these big orders get put in and you'll see walls also there. So now we're getting some shares that actually go through there on, let's say, like XOM for me. You're starting to see XOM here, 88, 90s. And so you can see here, I'm going to go to XOM. So you guys can see that. Now you're starting to see some volume step up there on XOM. We went to a low of 88.77. I could still put in one more ad, but that's a good sign for me if I'm looking for bottoming action, right? So that's for XOM, but it's the same way you could be looking at it for some other plays. All right, let's keep going. Technicals on CPG. Yeah, I got you. I got you in 2 seconds here. We got about 5 minutes left here. Mitch has earned 10 units of free will for playing a copyrighted song. You guys know I don't shy away from the copyrights. They can come after me. I'll get over it. All right, let's go ahead. Let's keep it going here. You guys wanted some reggae. I'll just go back to my my go-to, like always. A little bit of some, you know what? Let's change it up here. Let's do... Tribal Seeds. Let's do some... I always love this one. Here, let's go with this one. The Movement. Let's go. All right, looking to see if we can get 88.75s coming through there on XOM so I can take my last buy there. And I see some shares coming in here right above it. Want to see those shares get pressured, then we could take some more shares ourselves. As we came on down there, we took a little bit of an ad here at 89.10s, right at the top of that candle. We're looking for one more dip to kind of add in there and look for the push back there towards VWAP. We want to see a close above 92 here to really show that strength. Hey, lunchtime for Beach Bum. Can't blame you. All right, let me make sure that we got the redirect set here for Benzinga Live. We're going to get you guys on over here with Benzinga Live, and they're going to be talking about saving money to fight inflation. I don't know how you save money to fight inflation because it's 8%, but maybe AB knows something that I don't, because it's hard to save 8% right now or find an 8% saving rate anywhere. So you guys let me know. Yeah, it looks like we're getting some nice bottoming action there around the 89s here. So it doesn't look too bad. Let's go ahead. Let's make sure that we get our below our entry here, but we're just going to be patient. I will add if I get down there towards the 88.75s. If not, let it come back up there. There's no point in rushing to it. Energy now down 3.61%. So is basic materials. Just getting the washout today. We'll see if we get a bounce back action towards the close. Tech also in that washout. Only thing I have in the green is defensives and healthcare. And even those didn't hold the strongest move. All right, can I get one more song in here before we get on out of here? Let's go ahead, let's do that. Let's do this one. I always love hearing this jam here, so let's take a look at this one. This is just more of a kind of hanging out kind of song. Tadlo, FKJ, Mazgo. Check this out, Tadlo, guys. All right, like always, guys, keep on battling in the markets. Like always, we never know when we're going to be in the green or into the red. The one thing that we want to do is stick to a system. Understand that maybe if you have like a strike three rule, you discipline there. And discipline really comes by what? Is by following your rules. You're not disciplined just because you're disciplined. It's actually an action, right? Discipline, it means that you know a limit and you abide by that limit. That's where a lot of traders get trouble in day trading, and they just keep up giving gains because they keep taking trades and they're looking for that next kind of ride on up. Don't search for the euphoria in trading. Search for some systematicness, right? Some quantifiable data that can give you that edge. We're all looking for edge, and edge really comes from what? Understanding a system and understanding execution. A lot of that's going to be taking data. So don't be afraid to take more and more data out there. If you're seeing, okay, so I want to take bull flags. So in this next week, I'm not going to trade. I'm just going to simply write down every time I see a bull flag, and I'm going to write success or failure at certain levels. Maybe it's the VWAP. This is how you go ahead and abide by a system and make a system. I know a lot of traders are probably learning out there, how do I make a system in the first place? We'll start testing some patterns, do some back testing. You guys can use back testing on Trend Spider. You guys can do back testing on Trade Ideas. You can do back testing on a lot of platforms. So back testing is another way to kind of do this. But I also like looking at the environment that we're in right now, so you guys can test it also. I hope you guys have a great day. Keep battling in the markets. I'm going to bring you guys on over to AB. I'll see you guys on Stock Market Movers. I'm going to go pick up an energy drink and turn on up at 1 p.m. So if you guys want to turn back up, find some momentum here, I'll definitely be back at 1 p.m. Up next, Benzinga Live. Smash the like if you guys enjoyed today's show. I know it was a little bit tougher like always, but we'll be back tomorrow. Keep it going here, guys.